We often encounter a variety of techniques used by individuals and academic bodies who are attempting to stem the flow of true historical knowledge. Indeed, many of the most controversial and compelling artifacts are often stolen, conveniently lost, or simply sold on by their original discoverer, never to be seen again. However, sometimes, these artifacts successfully make it into the public domain, photographed and studied by reliable figures, before these vanishing acts can occur. And our next artifact is no exception. Predictably, the tactic that is seemingly chosen for these particular smoking guns is for the academic and scientific worlds to simply ignore such objects as if they do not exist. Or, as with this particular upart, to dismiss it, to look away, and claim it is simply impossible. Known as the Nampa doll, it is a small figurine confirmed beyond doubt as having once been crafted by the hands of man. It was discovered in 1889 by a group of workers who were searching for water near the town of Nampa in southwestern Idaho. They were attempting to create a well, drilling a borehole down to a depth of 295 feet, at which point they began to bring up strange cuts of clay. Amongst them was a unique projectile, a tiny clay figure in the shape of a woman. Professor Albert A. Wright of Oberlin College officiated the figure's authenticity in 1979, making academia's attempts to vanish the out-of-place figure near impossible. Quote, "It was not the product of a small child or amateur, but was made by a true artist. Though badly battered by time, the doll's appearance is still distinct. It has a bulbous head with barely discernible mouth and eyes, broad shoulders, short thick arms, and long legs. There are also faint geometric markings on the figure, which represent either clothing patterns or jewelry. They are found mostly on the chest or around the neck, arms, and wrists. The doll is the image of a person of a high civilization, artistically attired. We find his conclusion of it being of a person of high civilization as the most compelling, further supporting our belief that the doll is a leftover remnant of a now lost civilization. And due to academia's dismissive attitude towards the stonework, it is lost as a result of their conspiratorial ignorance. Furthermore, and an additionally intriguing reality, is the dating of the artifact. The geological strata it was discovered amongst is known as the Glens Ferry Formation, that, according to the same entities that deny the artifact's existence, was created approximately 2 million years ago during the Pliocene-Pleistocene transition. Additionally, before the mass cover-up of artifacts, research, and indeed evidence from the public domain, George Frederick Wright, a geologist from the Boston Society of Natural History, also confirmed this astonishing object's authenticity. Quote, "There is no ground to question the fact that this image came up in the sand pump from the depth reported. In visiting the locality in 1890, I took special pains while on the ground to compare the discoloration of the oxide upon the image with that upon the clay balls still found among the debris, and ascertained it to be as nearly identical as it is possible to be. These confirmation evidences, in connection with the very satisfactory character of the evidence furnished by the parties who made the discovery, confirmed by Mr. G.M. Gumming of Boston, who is the superintendent of that division and who knew all the parties, placed the genuineness of the discovery, in my mind, beyond reasonable doubt." End quote. How could a figurine, dated at 2 million years old, identified as having come from a technologically advanced civilization, exist? Authenticated by a number of official and highly trained individuals, if indeed there has never been another technologically advanced civilization to have flourished here upon our planet. We find the fact that academia is simply attempting to dismiss its existence proof of their concealment of this truth, making the Nampa figurine undoubtedly highly compelling.